morning, everyone. I invite you to join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
There are many flags in many lands. There are flags of every hue. But there is no flag, however grand, like our own red, white, and blue. Then hurrah for the flag, our country's flag. Its stripes and white stars do. There is no flag like our own red, white, and blue. We shall always love the stars and stripes, and we ever shall be true to this land of ours and the dear old flag, our own red, white, and blue. Then hurrah for the flag, our country's flag, its stripes and white stars too.
Good morning, Sag Harbor Elementary. Today is Monday, April 27th, 2020. The weather forecast today is partly cloudy with a chance of showers. Get outside anyway. And if you have a pet, get them outside too. Today in history. Ulysses S. Grant, the 18th President of the United States, was born in Point Pleasant, Ohio. Trivia fact. President Grant, who was a general during the U.S. Civil War, loved horses. But I learned that he had some dogs, too. A Newfoundland named Faithful and a black and tan mixed breed named Rosie. Have a great day!
Molly, thank you for helping with the announcements.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Monday morning. I hope you enjoyed the weekend. Wasn't Saturday a beautiful day? I'm sure everyone got a chance to enjoy some things outside, and let's hope that we see some weather just like that in the days to come. We're heading into week 7, and boys and girls, over the last few weeks I've shared with you that I've been meeting with your teachers and the teachers throughout the building, and collectively we're all so impressed with the effort that each and every one of you is putting in. And a big part of this remote learning experience is you being an independent learner at many times during the day. The plan for you is laid out, but there is a lot of independence that's required. And we are so very proud of the way that you have approached this whole new experience. So I do want to remind you that you are not alone during this remote journey. Of course, you have your families at home. Your parents have been a vital part in supporting your learning over the last few weeks. And during our daily schedules, we have set the time aside known as office hours. And many of you have been accessing your teacher's support during that time. But if you have not yet, please make sure you reach out to the different teachers because they are eager and willing to help you with any of the learning assignments that you have. And if you have any challenges, they want to support you and figure out a way that you can do your best on your different assignments. I hope everyone enjoys the day, and I'll look forward to seeing you throughout the week.
Join me in celebrating a few birthdays. Happy birthday, Samantha Flores. And today, Evie Berkowski celebrates her birthday. Enjoy your day, girls.
Happy birthday, everybody. Happy Harbor Elementary. Happy Monday. I hope you all had a lovely weekend. I want to give a quick shout out to my daughter, Evie. It's her 9th birthday today, so happy birthday, Evie. I hope you have a fabulous day, and happy birthday to everybody else who's celebrating today. So I've chosen an idiom for this week, and the idiom that I've chosen is one that I personally have thought about a lot in this situation that we're in, and that is light at the end of the tunnel. So light at the end of the tunnel means when you can start to see signs of improvement in a situation that has been bad for a long time, or the signs that a long and difficult piece of work is almost finished. So I think we can all agree that at some point in this crazy COVID-19 pandemic that we're in, we have all thought to ourselves, when are we going to see light at the end of the tunnel? When are things going to get better? When are we going to resume to life in a normal way that we were used to operating like before? I know I want to know when we're going back to school. I want to know when I can see my friends again. I want to know when I can go to the grocery store without having to wear a mask. And the answer to that is I don't think people quite know. But I do know this, that there are a lot of people all over the world working really hard to try to make this situation better. They are trying to make it so that we will see light at the end of this tunnel, okay? So I always try to remember to stay positive in this, you know, rather tricky situation. So where does this idiom come from? It was actually kind of tricky for me to find where it originated, but it definitely relates to a dark and dangerous tunnel. And when you near the end, you can see the sunlight, and therefore you can see out, and that the end of a difficult situation is almost there. The light that you see at the end of the tunnel represents hope. Okay? So my example is every day that I am home, I turn on the news and hope to see that there is light at the end of the tunnel so that we can return to school and to be together again. I think the thing I miss the most is being at school with all of you guys. That's been really hard. It's not really the same doing Google Hangouts with all of you. So I keep hoping that we're going to see light at the end of this tunnel. And since it's poetry month, I did want to share a poem with you. And this poem just sort of reminded me that it's always important to stay positive. Even though you kind of get a little bit bummed out, try to stay as positive as you can, and we will see light at the end of this tunnel. We don't know when, but it will happen. So I found this poem on Facebook, and it was inspired by the writing of Dr. Seuss. And you're supposed to read it with a Dr. Seuss type rhythm. So here's the poem I'd like to share with you. The buildings were big and people would smile, and travel they would mile by mile. But sick they become, in numbers it grew. Businesses worried, communities too. Things stopped for a bit, the world slowed its roll. The virus had certainly taken its toll. But what they then saw from slowing things down is, in fact, they now had less reasons to frown. Families now gathered, one game, what game shall we play? Pass me the blue crayon, give mommy the gray. Hey, dad's home, guys, he'll read us a book. Then all of us together will cook. The lungs of the planet caught a small break. Less travel meant less pollution to make. People did realize they'd all be okay. They don't need so much to get through the day. Maybe this virus that caused so much stress showed the whole world that more can mean less. Inspired by Dr. Seuss. And then at the bottom, you can see it says, stay positive. So, like I said, I know we're all wondering when we're going to see light at the end of this tunnel, but remember to try to stay positive. Try to think glass half full, stay optimistic, and we will get through this, and we will start to see that light soon enough. All right. Have a great week, everybody, and I will be back next Monday.
Hey, Sag Harbor Elementary, how are you guys? I don't know what you guys have been doing to take care of our planet Earth in celebration of Earth Day, but boy, did Mother Nature thank us on Saturday. Wasn't that a gorgeous day that we had? Thank you so much for the pictures. Thank you so much for the videos. And remember, we celebrate Earth Day only one day, but we take care of it all year long. I miss you guys. See you later. Bye.
got to move. You can feel it all over. They can feel it all over the people. They can feel it all over. They can feel it all over the people. Duke.